Hey, what up? Here's my little piece on Annihilation of 2018. It's a film. Let's first address some of the stuff you heard about the movie before the movie came out. Basically, what happened was the characters that are played by the two main white leads, and basically they were the two top leads. They're supposed to be Asian and I think Native American. Basically the excuse the director gave and the actresses gave was they were for diversity, and they did not know, and they said the race was not mentioned in their script or whatever, so they just went with the default, which is white characterization. I think to address that, I think one of the things we got to learn to get over is being what is default? You know what I mean? People are always saying we are all human, we all bleed the same, etc., etc. Well, we got to start thinking with that attitude when it comes to the film industry and work, you know what I mean? If we want to talk about diversity and actually live by it, we got to stop thinking that the default is a white character, you know what I mean? The default, logically and reasonably speaking, could be anyone, you know what I mean? In a book, you don't just read it and just assume it's white because no race was mentioned, you know what I mean? And even Alex Garland admitted that he may have had a subconscious bias to it. So that's part of my take on it. And the other factor is it's all about equal opportunity and hiring. You know what I mean? It's not about, hey, let's just hire strictly on race with zero qualifications, right? But they do hire on race. Some of your favorite characters and writings are based on the race of white people, like Superman. They use a white guy every time. Batman, they use a white guy every time. Captain America, another white guy every time. But no one ever complains that they never used qualifications there. So why is it an issue when a person is a person of color? You know what I mean? It doesn't mean that it's not, they're not going to be qualified. Look at Black Panther. They went, out of their way to make sure it was aesthetically and culturally correct by hiring black people. And whatever your opinion is, they weren't qualified to do the job. You know what I mean? And that's all it is about at the end of the day. It wouldn't matter if they replaced the character with a white person or change the race once in a while, but it just seems too much of a coincidence that every time it's done to favor a white actor. It just shows they think the default is a white person, and it's not fair because there are people that want to work in the industry. They work hard, they're qualified, but they never get a chance in the door because of that. So, at the end of the day, I think, if we are going to do that, then equally give the opportunity to the others, too. You know what I mean? If you're going to replace a white, a black character, an Asian character with a white one, then do the opposite. A white character, replace it with, a Chinese person or a black person that's, etc., that's qualified for the job. You know what I mean? And get rid of your innate biases, you know what I mean? Sometimes the most qualified person is a person of color, you know what I mean? So that's my take on that. So it's all about equal opportunity, you know what I mean? There are lots of black actors, Asian actors, female actors, Latino actors, Native American exactly. They just want to be represented on screen and have the same opportunity to work and do their art. So That's my sidebar rant on that. So now let's talk about the film. The film in and of itself, when you look at it, the cinematography, the plot, and the filming, it's not too intelligent like they were saying. They were saying it wasn't going well with audiences because they're claiming it was too smart for them. And I don't know, that just sounds like kind of like high sedity, and they think they're better than everyone just because someone just doesn't happen to like it. You know what I mean? There's a difference between hate and they just didn't like it. It's a piece of art. It's subjective. But to claim it's too smart is just, I don't know, I think it's kind of reaching a little bit. You know what I mean? I watched it. I understood the whole thing. And I can kind of see why it didn't go too well with a lot of the audiences, because, like, I don't know if it was the director or maybe it was the actors that wanted to do it that way, but their demeanor throughout the film was kind of like lacked emotional content and energy and personality. I don't know if it was done on purpose, but it seemed that way, all the characters. And it kind of lulls people. And also the cinematography and the plot and everything, it comes off like a B movie, like a straight to video. Now, not to say something straight to video back in the days, like when we used to go to Blockbuster to rent movies, right? That it can't be good. Like, obviously, they can't be good, but it was kind of like, it was okay. You know what I mean? So, basically, the story is, there's an area on Earth, it's kind of like you're entering another dimension. They call it the Shimmer. And I won't go into the full details of it, but how it was created and everything. It's basically a mutating landscape, and they enter it. And all the characters that enter it also face abnormalities and changes while they're going through the Shimmer. Some of the effects were good, and other times it was kind of it felt like a TV film, like something you see on sci-fi. Basically, the actors, I guess they did an okay job. I really liked Tessa Thompson and Gina Rodriguez. I haven't seen a lot of her work, but she was pretty good in it. I'd say she was better than Natalie Portman and Jennifer Jason Leigh. Like, she had more personality and emotional content when she was performing her character. You know what I mean? Even though she was not as billed as high as Portman or Jennifer Jason Leigh, she was a lot better, in my opinion. So, Natalie Portman, she did a pretty good job with her character. There wasn't much to it. But it just kind of felt like she wasn't into it. I don't know if she meant to play it that way, or maybe the director told her to play it that way. Or maybe it was the effect of her going to the Shimmer. However, the characterization was kind of similar even before the Shimmer. So, all in all, I'd say it's okay. I'd give it like a 6.75 out of 10. And that's that. Also, Benedict Wong is in it. He plays one of the scientists. Forgot to cover that. But yeah, basically I think 6.75 out of 10. I can see why audiences didn't quite go well with it. It's kind of too mellow to be interesting. And that's that. Peace.